Okay, alternator on load. Okay, this is the topic today we are going to see about alternator on load. What will happen when alternator is connected to load? When alternator is connected to load, its voltage will come down. Why it is coming down? That's the thing we are going to analyze. Okay, this is the no load voltage. No load voltage, if it's, I am taking a, so before that, what is meant by phase value, what is meant by line value? Actually, this is the alternator, this is the stator, this is the field winding, electromagnet, this is connected to the prime mover, DC supply is given to this thing, DC supply given to this to convert this electromagnet, this iron piece into magnet, this DC supply is given, normally to 110 volt or 220 volt is given. Okay, this is connected to the power, this is the rotor, this is the stator. Here we are having three windings, we are having, this is R phase, Y phase, B phase. If you measure the voltage across this thing, this is called phase voltage. See, only one phase voltage, this is another phase voltage, another phase voltage, three phase voltages are there. This we cannot measure because this will be inside the yoke, it will be available. This is the neutral point. Okay, this we cannot measure. We can measure only the line voltage. Okay, what is the relation between line voltage and phase voltage? In a star connected network, line voltage will be equal to root 3 times of phase voltage. This value we know, that's the thing. Similarly, what the value of armature, this is line current, this current is called line current, this current is called phase current, this current is called line current, both the current will be same. So line current will be equal to phase current will be equal to line current, both the current will be same. Okay, up to this only I have not touched this thing, okay. If I have not connected to the load, what will happen? Suppose I have not connected to this, I have opened. Actually, this load will be connected at almost 20 to 50 kilometers, 100 kilometers apart from this thing, because alternator will be connected. Hydro power plant means, for example, it will be in the metro where the dam are constructed, there only power plant will be there. Where the load will be there, load will be 100 kilometers away, far away from this thing only. So I have not mentioned this thing. Okay, whether we have to connect the alternator, yes, we have to connect. Then only we have to connect the alternator. There is no use of generating power. We have to utilize then and there. Okay, this is the thing I have opened. If I open this thing, what is the amount of voltage generated here? Means this full no load voltage will be available. This voltage is called E phase because the current, no current will flow through this thing. This voltage is called no load voltage. If I connect the load, what do you think? Current will flow. What are the current? Line current, that is load current, here will flow, here will flow. Three load current will flow. We are taking only one value, that is for one phase only we are taking, that is called phase value. If I consider all the three cases, that is called three phase. Normally we won't consider three phases, only one phase we will consider. So one phase voltage, this voltage will be equal to this. V phase will be equal to, actually green color is not visible. So no load voltage E phase will be equal to load voltage equal to load voltage plus, there will be three drop will be occurring. Where this drop will occur means inside the alternator it will occur. Due to this current it will occur, plus IA into XL drop plus IA into XAR drop. These are all are vector quantities. Three drop will occur. So what are the drop? One is IARA, IAXL, IAXAR, XAR. Okay. What are these drop? What is the thing? If current is not there, this three drop won't occur. When current won't be there? When there is no load at all. But we have to connect the alternator to load. Once the alternator is connected to load, these three drop will occur. What are this thing? IA into RA. IA into RA means nothing but voltage drop due to armature resistance. Which armature resistance? There are three windings are there, but we are considering only one armature, because remaining we are not considering, that's all, only one armature. If here we are having armature made up of copper, so this will have some resistance RA, because since it is having, when current flow through this thing, automatically which drop will occur? IA RA drop will occur. This we cannot avoid. So we can minimize. How can we minimize? By having less copper wind, less amount of resistance that we can use. That's the thing only we can go. Okay, next thing, IA into XL drop. What is mean by IA XL drop? That is due to voltage drop due to armature leakage reactance. What is mean by leakage reactance? When current flows through the circuit, that there being the armature winding, when current flows through the armature winding, when the current flow, when the load is connected, a flux will be created in the armature, which called armature flux. This is called main flux. The flux created by the main coil is called main flux. The flux, when the current flows through the thing, a flux will be created here. That flux is called armature flux phi A. For this flux, what will happen? The current, when current flows like this thing, some of the flux will produce and it will make a closed path. it will produce a closed path. This won't affect this main flux. This won't affect the main flux, but it, what will happen? It will close, it will make a closed path. It will, some flux will affect the main flux, that we will see in the armature reaction. Armature reaction will take case, the armature flux will affect the main flux, that we will see in the armature reaction. Here's armature leakage reactant, the leakage flux. What leakage flux means? In the sum of the flux, the sum of the armature flux, sum of the armature flux will make a closed path. So this will make the armature, this will make the armature inductive in nature, inductive in nature. Thus leakage flux is called IAXL drop. This will also occur, this we cannot avoid. The third drop is called armature reaction drop. What is mean by armature reaction drop? Same thing. See, one flux here we are having, that is the main flux. That is due, that is the thing to produce main main voltage. If the flux is not there, voltage won't produce. That's the thing. Another flux will there, which is called armature flux. But when compared to main flux, armature flux will be very small in nature. Even though it will react with this main flux and it will, something will happen. What is mean by something? That something depends upon the load. Okay, whether it will assist the main flux, whether it opposes the main flux, everything depends upon the load. Okay, if there are three types of load we have to consider. First type of a resistive load is nature. The second thing, if we are having inductive, the load is inductive in nature. If we are having capacitive load is nature. Three cases we have to analyze when the, what happened to this armature reaction. Okay, this armature reaction is many, it is the main thing. Because the thing is that when compared to that IARA drop, IAXL drop, this IARA drop will be very high when compared to these three things. So this will have more impact on the voltage. Okay, so we have to see separately about the armature reaction. Okay, this is only introduction about this thing. A four more question followed by this thing is an armature reaction. That is alternator and load is an just introduction to this thing. The next thing is that armature reaction. What is armature reaction? What is armature reaction? Armature reaction. What is armature reaction? The effect of armature flux on main flux. The effect of armature flux on main flux. The armature flux will be very less in nature. For example, it will be only 5 Weber like this thing. But this main flux will be 100 Weber like this thing only. We cannot compare this. Even it will be, actually it won't be like this thing. It will be 0.5 Weber like this thing. It will be 100 Weber like this thing. But we can, but even though it will affect this thing. So both will, what will happen? Both will add or each other, or both will oppose each other. No, it depends upon load. Already I have told, it depends upon load. Consider, let us consider three cases, line by line we will consider. First case 1. First case 1, what is the load means? It is pure or resistive load. Resistive load. Resistive load or what kind of unity power factor load? UPF, unity power factor load. Both are same because resistive load. Okay. Here, what I am taking? I am taking main flux as a reference. What is mean by main flux? This main flux I am taking as a reference. I have to find the phi a value I have to find, and I have to find the relation between these two things. But I am taking main flux as a reference. Next, what I have to do? What are the thing? How will be the voltage? Due to this main flux only, what the EMF is generated? What is EMF? EMF, we know that E equal at Faraday's law, E equal to d phi divided by dt. So it will be d phi by dt. So voltage, generated voltage will be 90 degree lagging the which voltage, which flux, main flux. So this is generated voltage E, generated voltage E phase. I am putting as E phase or V phase, anything I can put V phase. Why is this 90 degree lagging? Because the E equal to d phi by dt. Okay, next thing. Okay, what is the type of load we are having? The type of load we are having is purely inductive in nature. Sorry, purely resistive in nature. In resistive load, voltage and current, due to this voltage only, current is flowing. Due to this voltage only, when I connect the load, current is flowing. So the current will be in phase with this thing. Why it is IA current? IA or IL, I can write both currents are same. It is a star connected network. Because we are having only star connected network. So both will be in phase because it is a resistive load. Okay, due to this armature current, which is produced, an armature flux is produced. So it will be also in phase with this thing. So see, I am taking main flux as a reference. The main flux, the generated voltage will be 90 degree lagging. This, due to this generated voltage, an armature current will flow when load is connected. Okay, this armature current will be in phase because it is a resistive load. Next, what we are going, then due to this armature current, so this, there will be armature flux will be produced in the armature conductor. That flux is called phi a. Now see the relation between these two things, phi m and phi a. What is the relation between the thing? Phi m is 90 degree, sorry, phi a is 90 degree lagging phi m. Suppose I am taking this as a reference, I am taking this as a time and this as a flux. Okay, and because all will be sinusoidal nature, all the fluxes are sinusoidal nature, everything is because it is a pure AC. So I am taking this flux. This is 0, this is 90 degree, this is 180, 270 and 360. This is main flux. Okay, how will be the armature flux will be there? Armature flux is 90 degree lagging. What is mean by 90 degree lagging? Lagging means right hand side. Leading means left hand side, lagging means right hand side. But this value magnitude will be very small. So I am putting like this thing. Before that it will be there. See, this is a continuous process. So I am therefore also it will be like this thing. Okay, so here I can segregate like this 0 to 90 degree, 90 to 180 degree, 180 to 270 degree, 270 to 360 degree. In the 0 to 90 degree, 0 to 90 degree, armature flux in positive, whereas the main flux is in positive direction, but the armature direction in negative thing. So both will oppose each other. 0 to 90 degree, both will oppose each other. After 90 to 120 degree, this is all the positive half cycle, armature flux also in the positive half cycle, so armature main flux also in positive half cycle. Both will add each other. See, 0 to 90 degree both will oppose, 90 to 180 degree both will add. After 180 to 270 degree, armature flux is positive, main flux is in negative, so both it will oppose. Then 270 to 360 degree both will add each other. So each and every 90 degree they are opposing and they are adding. So how much time in 1 second, how much cycle will be there? That is called frequency. 50 cycles will be there. So 50 cycles means 50 into 4, 200 times it will be there. So 100 times it will oppose in 1 second, 100 times it will oppose, 100 times it will add each other, additive in nature. That is armature flux and main flux. In 1 second, armature flux and main flux, it will add and it will oppose. In 1 second, 100 times it will add, 100 times it will oppose. So what will happen? So totally what will happen? Nothing will happen. But the thing is that there will be some distortion will be there. Some distortion will be there. So the voltage will slightly come down. Slightly it will come down. We cannot say come up. Actually, it should not come down, but due to some distortion, it will come down. This is the effect on armature flux and main flux in which type of load? R load, inductive load. Next we are going to, which is resistive load. Next case 2, what is the thing we are going to do? Pure inductive load. Inductive load means not pure inductive load, just an inductive load. It is an inductive load. What is an inductive load? In the inductive load, what will happen? Inductive load, main flux is there. Okay, how the current inductive load, or I can say as RL load. Because pure inductive load, there is no pure inductive load at all. Any load will be there, even wire will consist of some resistance, and the inductive also will consist of some resistance. So we cannot say as a pure inductive load. In inductive load, how will be there? I am taking this as a reference. Okay, I am taking which as a reference? Main flux as a reference. Due to this main flux, which is generated, E phase is there. Okay, so here I am taking pure inductive load. I will take a pure inductive load. Pure inductive load. That is zero power factor load. Pure inductive load. Purely inductive load. Actually, it's not practical case. It is an ideal case. Let us assume this is an ideal. Pure inductive load. Okay. If it is, we are taking main flux as a reference. Okay. So the voltage will be generated due to E phi by dt, Faraday's law. So it will be in E phi by nature. How will be the current will be there? Since it's a purely inductive load. Okay. The current will be 90 degree lagging. 90 degree lagging means in which direction? 90 degree. Say 90 degree lagging means this direction. Here we will have this direction. This will be current IA current. Okay. Phi A will be what you think? So automatically phi A will be in this direction. See, I have not taken. This is an ideal case only. Practically, it won't be purely inductive load. It is an ideal case. Okay, pure inductive load. Suppose it is a pure inductive load, what will happen? Okay. So 90 degree it will lags. Okay, now what is the relation between phi M and phi A? Both are opposing each other. Suppose I am drawing a graph. Okay, I am drawing a graph. See, I am taking which as reference? I am taking, this is flux and this is time. I am taking, this is main flux. How the armature flux will be there? How much degree angle it is lagging? It is lagging by an angle 180 degree. So it will be like this thing. Exactly, it is 180 degree lagging. This is 0, 90, 180, 270, and this is 360. So always you can see always what is happening. Main flux is positive half cycle and armature flux is negative half cycle. When this is a negative half cycle, this is positive half cycle. So both is opposing, both are opposing at each and every time. So the resultant flux phi r will be equal to phi m minus phi a. Armature flux. This so the total flux will come down. Definitely it will come down. When the total flux come down, automatically what EMF generated will be reduces. The voltage will come down. Okay. This is the due to which type of load? It is due to pure inductive load. Ideal case, pure inductive load. Okay. Third case I am going to pure capacitive load. What is mean by happen to pure capacitive load? This is case 3. This is case 2. I have seen the third one is pure capacitive load. Case 3. Pure capacity load. Okay, pure capacity load means how the current is, see, these are all same, up to this thing is same. Okay, up to this thing is same. E phase, what happened to current? Current will be in pure capacity, current leads the voltage by an angle how much degree? 90 degree. Leads means this thing, this current will be in this thing. So due to this current which is produced, phi a is produced. Okay, now we can see that what is the relation between phi m and phi a. Both are in phase. So both are in phase means what will happen? Both will add each other. Both will see, it will be like this thing. See, the magnitude will be very small only. This magnitude will be, main flux will be very much high, whereas the armature flux is very much low. Even though maybe also it will have some impact, it will have, it will have some impact. Okay, so what will happen? Both are additive in nature. So resultant flux will be phi m plus phi r. So what will happen? The total flux will increase. The total flux will increase, so that what happened, the voltage will, the load voltage will be more than the no load voltage. But practically there is no capacity load at all. We are having 90% of load are inductive in nature and 10% of our load are resistive in nature. So we are having only RL type of load only. There is no pure capacity load at all. Okay, but this is the effect of armature reaction. Okay, how can we write this thing? Means first one, case one, pure resistive load. What is happening? There will be this called cross magnetization. That is called cross magnetization. What is meant by cross magnetization? Because one half cycle, that is 0 to 90 degree, both are opposing. And 90 degree, 180 degree, it is additive. So like this, it is happening. This is called cross magnetization. In inductive load, both are opposing. Main flux, armature flux oppose the main flux. This is called demagnetization. Demagnetization effect. And this here, both are add each other. This is called magnetization effect. That we have to write. That is called result. Okay, that is the result. This is called magnetization effect. So first one is resistive load, demagnetization effect. Inductive load, resistive load, cross magnetization effect. Inductive load, demagnetization effect, and this thing, cross magnetization effect. So these are the three cases we have seen. This is also a 4-mark question. Sometimes they may ask in a 6-mark question. Okay, so the armature reaction is nothing but the effect of armature flux on main flux. It depends upon the load. We are having three cases. Okay, this thing, this is a 4-mark question. Sometimes they may ask in 6-mark question also. Okay, but you have to draw the actual this phasor diagram, this thing, as both the things are main important. Both the things you have to draw. Okay, apart from small written, some small explanation you have to write, what will happen, all those things. Okay, thank you.